Hi guys, I'm Chandu. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to review Nokia 55-inch Ultra HD 4K LED Smart Android TV. Guys, this review is after 6 months of usage, so I will explain each and every detail of TV with its pros and cons. So let's get started. I purchased this TV from Flipkart, which is the official partner for Nokia TVs in India, which comes with an integrated soundbar by well-known Japanese brand Onkyo. So, before we get started, let's just have a look at the specifications. The processor is CA55 quad-core processor. The graphic processor is Mali 470 quad-core processor. The panel type is VA panel. The resolution is 3840 by 2160 pixels. It comes with 2GB RAM and it comes with a 16GB onboard storage. The Android operating system was 9. The soundbar output is 48 watts. The refresh rate is 60Hz. It comes with 3 HDMI ports and 2 USB ports. The Wi-Fi type is a single band 2.4. So first, let's get started with main highlight of TV was Onkyo 48W soundbar. This is the main thing that it stands one of the best TVs compared to other TVs in terms of audio. So before purchasing any TV, we see the audio output, which gives us a better sound experience. And yes, this TV had a great sound output. The soundbar is located in lower bezel of TV with 2 Quattro X speaker and comes with 30W speaker with 18W tweeters in it with a very good premium fabric look. It supports various audio formats. So let's just have a look and listen to the audio with varying volume. I can't increase more volume as it is so loud in my room. As seen, the sound output is so high, very dynamic and crystal. The audio has good highs and mids, but the bass is not like a home theater, but it's a pretty decent one. I do have a Zebronics home theater for my TV, as I'm a bass lover. If you want to have a good bass experience, the home theater is suggested. But if you listen through TV, trust me guys, the sound was very loud in the room. So finally, it has a very good sound output. So coming to the display, we have the resolution of 3840 by 2160 pixels display. This is a VA panel, as VA stands for vertical alignment, and it is a type of LED panels display technology. VA panels are characterized having the best contrast and image depth among the other main types of display panels, and the color reproduction is quite good. VA panels has more advantages over TN panels than IPS panels, with better color reproduction, higher maximum brightness and better viewing angles. It has a contrast ratio of 5000:1 for overall performance. With HDR10, VA panel is better. This TV has 420 nits of brightness, where the Nokia TV stands with no competition at this price point. The colors are so good and vivid, and they are not oversaturated. The viewing angle mentioned was 178 degrees, but whereas if you have a view more than 45 degrees, you can see the color differs somehow. So if I sit in a diagonal view, the viewing experience is not up to the mark. The display comes with 60Hz refresh rate, where the videos run so smooth and we can watch 4K videos in YouTube without any lag. The brightness levels are so good and crisp, so the viewing experience was quite good. It comes with micro dimming, AI engine, AI sound, advanced contrast ratio, supports HDR10 and it also supports many more video formats. So coming to the OS, it is running on Android 9 OS with multiple supported apps. So coming to the OS experience, the apps run so smooth, like Netflix, Prime, YouTube, etc., where there is no lag in these apps, and this Android TV comes with App Store. We can download multiple apps and games as well. I don't actually play in TV, but yeah, I tested the games as well. The games run so smoothly. This Nokia 55-inch TV comes with 2GB RAM, which is good for multitasking, and 16GB onboard storage, which is quite good for downloading necessary apps. It also comes with two-way Bluetooth functionality, which is one of the best features, whereas we can connect Bluetooth to TV and stream the content alone. And second one, it can be used as a standby music soundbar and can connect with mobile to enjoy the music, where we can turn off the display as well. The first option is if you want to connect to TV Bluetooth with mobile, the content can be streamed. Whereas if you connect mobile via Bluetooth to second option in audio settings, only audio will be played within the soundbar. The TV comes with mirroring and Chromecast in it, so that you can cast different apps from mobile to TV and enjoy the streaming. Now we'll check casting option. There is an app called Fastcast for Nokia TV, especially for casting. So we'll have a look into this. We can stream the movies flawlessly. The TV has a built-in Google Voice Assistant. It is so quick and responsive, and also comes with Google Home, and also compatible with gamepad. Remote has a minimalistic design, and this smart remote comes with two AAA batteries in it, and it comes with hotkeys like Z5 and Netflix, whereas they could have given Prime Video on it. The remote is quite compact in hand. First, let's just have a look at the settings. First, coming to the network and internet, we can see the Wi-Fi connections here. It is a single band Wi-Fi, so you can connect to a single band Wi-Fi connection here and add any network. It also comes with a data server. We can switch it on, switch it off. It comes with data usage and alerts, so you can monitor all the data usage related here. And we can limit that notifications also, like 100 MB or 500 MB. And the other options you can see, like proxy settings and IP settings. So we'll just look at accounts and sign in. Here we can sign in with our Google account. So coming to the apps, all the downloaded apps we can see here. We can open the Prime Video app and can see like open, force stop, uninstall updates, disable, storage used, clear data, clear catcher, clear defaults, notifications, permissions, all we have in this. And let's just come back and we can see the all other apps installed here. Coming to the app permissions, you can see it has body sensors, calendar, call logs, camera, contacts, location, microphone, phone, SMS, storage, additional permissions like car information, read all TV settings, etc. You can see all the additional informations here. Coming to the special app access, it has energy optimization, where you can optimize all the apps. You can switch off, switch on this energy optimization, and you can see the usage access also, so that you can switch on, switch off it. You have notification access, you can enable it. We can have a display over other apps, so you can switch on, switch off in it. And coming to the modify system settings, you can modify here, you can switch off in this. And coming to security and restrictions, the first option is unknown resources. It shows allow installation of apps from sources other than the Play Store. And coming to the device preferences, we'll go to about and we'll see, check the system update. Here I'm checking for the update. I already updated for the latest version. So we'll just check any other update pop up here. So no, my system is up to date. And here we have the device name. We can change it, rename it or whatever. Here we have the reset option. Here the status of this TV. We have IP address, MAC address, Bluetooth address, serial number, uptime. This is all about legal information, open source licenses, etc. And the model number, here we can see the model number of the TV. And it comes with an Android 9 version, Android Pie version. You can see the logo is popping up. The Android security patch level, it was last November 2020. And we can see the kernel version and build number 2. And coming to the date and time, we have automatic date and time. We can switch on to the automatic date, or we can switch to 24-hour format also. And we can set the time zone, whatever the required time zone you want. And coming to the language, here we can switch on to several languages. You can see on the display, as it is a default English. And coming to the keyboard, the current keyboard is Gboard. Here you can have the Gboard settings, like you can set the languages and you can see all the other options like open source licenses, and here we can manage the keyboards too. Coming to the sound settings, here we can enable or disable the system sounds, and we can select the format of audio. In default it was in auto mode. Coming to the storage, it comes with 16 GB onboard storage. Here you can see the statistics of the storage, regarding like downloads, apps, photos, videos and available storage too. And coming to this home screen, here you can customize your home screen. You can enable video previews, enable audio previews, and we can have a recorder apps that record this whatever the apps we have. And coming to the recorder games, we can record the games on the TV. We have that option too. And we have open source licenses. Coming to the Google Assistant, we can switch on, switch off the Google Assistant, and we can enable the searchable apps. We can enable all the apps if you want, so that it can search directly through the apps. And we have the open licenses all too. And comes to the Chromecast, it comes with a casting option. We can cast from mobile to TV anywhere. And coming to the screensaver, here we can have a screensaver on or off, like we can switch on to backdrop or colors. Here we can also have the option when it can be started, like it can be started like 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour, whatever it is. And put device to sleep, you can enable this option when you want to put your TV to sleep mode. Okay, coming to the developer options, here we can enable or disable these developer options. You can see there are multiple options to enable or disable. Here we can see USB debugging mode. Here we can see wireless display certification, and we can see many more options, like we can see the pointer location we can enable or disable. We can also set the window animation scale if you want. If you don't want, you can switch off the animation scale too. Here you can see force GPU rendering, switch on, switch off. There are multiple options here we can enable or disable, depends on your requirement. And coming to this location option, here we can enable or disable the location. And coming here to usage and diagnostic, you can switch on or switch off the usage diagnostics. And coming to the accessibility, here we can enable the captions. We can see there are many more options like style, size. We can have the fonts, the text flashing, text color, text opacity, the edge type, edge color, show background. We do have several options to enable or disable the captions. Also, we can enable the text to speech mode. Here Google text to speech engine, like you can configure that too. And coming to the accessibility, we can create an accessibility shortcut, we can enable it. And coming to the talkback access, we can enable and we can configure it too. You can see the option, we have speech volume, verbosity, speak passwords. It comes with tutorial and help, advanced settings, and it comes with the controls, whatever the license is required. It comes with all these things. And coming to the switch access, here we can enable, and you can see the configuration like open setup guide, assign switches for scanning, assign switches for global actions and menu customizations, customize scannings, there are display and sound. You can customize according to your switch access requirements. And here it comes with a reboot option too. And coming to remotes and accessories, here we can add our accessories like Bluetooth devices and all. Here I connected my home theater and here I connected my remote too. And coming to the Google Assistant, here we can use the Google Assistant directly. You can see how it's responding. And also we will check the YouTube how the voice assistant works. And this is how the home screen looks like after we switch on the TV. Here we can see all the installed apps and the apps which comes with inbuilt TV. You can see there are many inbuilt apps like Z5 Premium, Spotify, Disney Hotstar, Hangama, Sony Live, Voot, Eros Now, and many more apps. So let's just open the Amazon Prime Video app and check how the quality actually looks like and how the video runs. I will just play a movie trailer so you can see the video quality here. Okay, coming to TV settings, we have external inputs. In external inputs, we have HDMI CEC settings. In CEC settings, we have CEC control, device auto power on off, TV auto power on, CEC device list, and device control keys. And coming to the support HDMI mode, we have 1.4 mode and 2.0 mode. And coming to the picture and display settings, we have picture adjustment and display settings. In picture adjustment, we can see the picture mode. We have dynamic, movie, sport, music, news. We can set according to our display filtering. And coming to the advanced settings, we have brightness. In brightness, we have backlight, contrast, gamma, black level, black adjust, dynamic contrast, and ECO settings. And coming to the color, we have saturation limit, hues, color temperature, and live color. And coming to the clarity, we have sharpness settings, 3D noise reduction, and we have black noise reduction settings. And finally, we have reset option in it. We can reset to the default options. Coming to the display settings, we have two options. One is screen mode and other is auto screen mode. In screen mode, we have 16:9 ratio and 4:3 ratio. We can select according to it. In auto screen mode, we can switch on or off the auto mode. And coming to the sound settings, in sound adjustment, we have sound modes like movie, music, news, standard. We can set according to our audio settings. And we can switch on, switch off the surrounded sound also. Coming to advanced settings, we have volume settings. In volume settings, we have auto volume, balance, digital audio out volume, digital audio out delay, and volume offset. And coming to the sound mode, we have sound effect. And we can reset the equalizer also. We can set the equalizer according to the sound band. And finally, we have a reset option for audio also. And coming to the TV placement, we have desktop option and wall mount option. Desktop is nothing but a table mount. And coming to the TV placement, already it was in default wall mount. And coming to the digital audio out, we have three options: auto, PCM, and Dolby Digital Plus. And coming to the smart zone, we have options like enjoy music. When we switch on the enjoy music, the screen goes off within the 5 seconds and the display goes blank. And next option, we have fast cast option where we can cast easily. And we have sleep timer, we can set sleep timer too. And we have a world clock. And finally, we have a night mode also. Coming to the inputs, we have ATV, antenna, cable, HDMI 1, HDMI 2, HDMI 3. Audio, video, Google Play Movies, and VLC. Okay, coming to the pros, it has excellent Onkyo built-in soundbar. It has 420 nits brightness. It comes with 2GB RAM. It has two-way Bluetooth functionality. It has good design with thin bezels. Cons: it comes with single band Wi-Fi support, which at this price range, most of the TV comes with dual band Wi-Fi support. The viewing angles could be better. The Google Assistant sometimes non-responsive. The on-off button sometimes non-responsive. The provision of ports when wall mounted is too difficult to reach the cables. Guys, coming to the conclusion, this is one of the best smart TV in this price range, so can go purchase it. I will put the link in the description. Go check it out. Finally, please like and subscribe to my channel for more videos and hit that bell icon. Thank you.